So good evening everyone, my name is Gaurav Kumar Jain and I welcome you on this amazing channel named Geeks for Geek School. So before diving into the lecture first, I would like to tell you about this incredible course that Geeks for Geeks has come up with. So it's the course based on data structure and algorithm. If you don't know about what a data structure is, so let me tell you about that first. You know, a computer program is basically a collection of instructions which is used to perform a specific task, right? Now for this a computer program, we need to store data and retrieve data and perform computations on data, right? So a data structure is a named location that can be used to store and organize data, and an algorithm is a collection of steps, right, to solve a particular problem. Now learning data structures and algorithms allow us to write efficient and optimized computer programs. So if you want to learn how to if you want to learn about data structures and algorithm, then this course is for you. So in this course we will provide you with live online classes, right? And this course is basically designed for 9th and 12th students. Okay, so if you want to get an overview of this course, you can come on this web page. You can find the link of this web page in the description section. So from there you can just copy the link and paste it in the URL part of your browser and you will automatically be redirected on this amazing web page we have designed. So this course is of 4 weeks and each week consists of 4 classes each. What are you going to learn in this course? So an insight into data structures and algorithm. There will be live problem solving sessions that we will provide you in this course, and there will be many more things that you are going to take away from this course. If you want to see the syllabus that will be covered in the online classes we will provide you in this course, so you can click this button and automatically a new tab will get open up on your device on which you'll see a PDF file. So in this PDF you'll find all the topics that will be covered in the classes we will provide you in this course, right? And we have divided the syllabus week wise. Means as you know that in the first week you are going to get 4 lectures, right? You're going to get 4 classes, and in each of these four lectures there will be different topics which will be covered. So we will start from very scratch point, and we'll first talk about some basic things, and then once you'll become confident in this data structures and algorithm, then we will explain you the advanced concepts like bubble sort, selection sort, merge sort. Then in week 3 there will be things like stack queue, priority queue, and you know there will be many more things which will be taught to you in the last 2 weeks, you know, some advanced things. So if you want to become a good data structure and algorithms developer, so you can take this course. So our DSC tutorial will guide you to learn different types of data structures and algorithms and their implementation in object-oriented programming languages like Python, C, C++, Java. So what you have to do for availing this course, you can come down over here and you just have to log in into the page and register yourself for this course. Our executive department will get in touch with you, and then you know, they will get all your details, and after that you can start taking the classes. If you want to know something else, some more information, if you want to get some more information about this course, so you can get in touch with our executive department, and you can find the toll-free number over here, right in the bottom of this page. In this question number 3, in the answer section you can find the toll-free number, or you can drop a mail to us on this geeks.classes@geeksforgeeks.org. Definitely we'll try to sort out each and every query of yours. right? And if you want to share it with me in the comment section, you're most welcome to do it. Okay, let's now dive into the Tinkercad platform. So today again, we are going to develop a very, very amazing and beautiful thing, the name of which is Digital Watch, right? So let's do that quickly. If you are not on your Tinkercad platform, Tinkercad dashboard, I would like to request you to please access it so that you can do this thing, whatever I'll tell you today in this tutorial, simultaneously with me. So for accessing the circuits environment, we can click on the click this circuits option, and that's what we need to see. Click this create new circuit option and it will redirect you to this, to that beautiful simulation environment, to that beautiful simulator on which you can develop, you can make virtual circuits. And while this is getting accessed on my device, I would like to tell you one thing, that if you are not aware about the basic concepts, if you don't know about the basic things like how to create account on this platform, how to use this platform, you want to know about this interface of this platform, so you guys can check out the very first tutorial which I shorted for this platform on this channel, right? So in that I explained everything right from the scratch, you know, how to create account, what all, how can you use these options, right? How can you use these options which are given over here on this interface? So everything was explained by me in the very first tutorial. So do check it out if you haven't checked it out yet, if you want to know about the basic things, right? Okay, so the first thing that we require for this alarm, for this, sorry, digital watch is an Arduino board. So let's quickly fetch it from here. Yeah, so that's the one I will use. Okay, then we need two push buttons. So this is our push button one, and then we can have one more push button over here, perfectly fine. Then one more component we require for getting the time reflected, and it is the LCD. Okay, LCD 16x2. So I'm putting it over here. I think here it will be fine. Yeah, perfect. Okay, so let's now begin with creating a complete circuit. So we have to connect all these components with each other so as to create a complete circuit. Just a second. Let me, perfectly fine. Okay, so the first thing I would like to do is, let's use this red wire and connect this terminal 2B with this terminal. So you can follow the same things, right? And the way I am creating a complete circuit now, you can also do the same by using the steps which I am showing you right now. Now we have this 5 volt pin over here. What we can do, because we have already connected this terminal 2B of both these switches together with the help of this wire, so we can simply now connect this terminal 2B of this switch. We can bring it from here. Then let's connect it to this terminal 2B like this. Okay, so what we have done, we have successfully connected this pin 5 of Arduino Uno R3 board with this terminal 2B. So now it is now these both push buttons are connected with this Arduino Uno R3 board. Okay, so now what else we have to do? We need to have two different resistors, one for this, okay, and the other for this push button, right? Fine. Now we can make use of a green wire, and let's connect this terminal 1A with this terminal 2 and terminal 1A with this terminal 2, perfectly fine. Now, the next thing we have to do is we have to connect both these terminals to the ground pin. You remember, we in one of the previous circuits, we used these push buttons and we connected terminal 1A to the ground pin. So, you always have to keep this in mind, that terminal 1A of this, these push buttons have to be connected to the ground pin, right? So, like this, we can connect it to the ground pin. Perfect. Okay. Just a second. Fine. So I'm done with connecting both these pins to this ground pin over here. Now the second thing I have to do is we can simply connect this terminal 1A with this pin, with any of these pins, any of these free pins over here. So I would like to use some other colored wire. Let's make use of this green orange color wire for connecting this terminal 2 with this pin number 9. So that's how we can do it, right? And then we can do the same thing with this pin also. So I'm connecting this terminal with this pin over here. Perfect. Okay, so sorry, I think I have to directly with this pin. Yeah, perfect. Now what we can do, we can simply, we have to now connect this LED to these push buttons and to this Arduino Uno R3 board. So let's do that. So that's the first pin, you know, this is the ground pin, and because it's a ground pin, so we have to now connect it to the ground pin of this Arduino Uno R3 board. So I'm going to make use of this black color wire and simply I can connect this with the ground pin of LCD like this, right? And then what else can we do? We have to then connect this ground pin, sorry, this contrast pin with this ground pin. And how to do that? We can use the same color wire and we can simply put it like this over here. Perfect, right? And similarly, we have to connect this read and write pin with this ground pin. You know, the way I am connecting these pins, in the same way you all have to also connect these pins like this, right? Okay, now what else we have to do? So we have this LED pin over here, LED cathode. We have to connect it to this read and write pin. So that's what you have to do first. You have to connect this ground pin with this ground pin of LED, and then you have to connect these pins of LEDs with each other the way I have connected. Right, let me know once you are done with that. Now after this thing, we have this VCC pin, this power pin over here. So as you guys know very well, we are going to make use of this red color wire. Let's connect this VCC pin with this 5 volt pin. So that's how we can connect it. Right, the next thing that we have to do is, we have now this pin, register select, right? We have this pin over here, which is pin number 4, register select. So we are going to now connect it to one of these free pins present on this Arduino Uno R3 board. So let's do one thing. Let's use, first of all, some other color from here. So I'm using this turquoise and I am connecting this with, so it's a little bit complex circuit. If you are not able to understand it, so you can check the basic things first, then you can come on this tutorial. Definitely the things will become simple for you guys, right? But if you want to be there, you are able, you know that you will be able to understand this thing very well, then you can be there in this tutorial. And you can follow the way I am connecting this. I'm making this complete virtual circuit. In the same way, you can also do that. You just have to follow these steps which I'm showing you. Now I have selected some other color. I've selected yellow color, and I would like to connect this enable pin. So that's the enable pin, and I am going to connect it with. So we have to now find out a pin over here to which we can connect it. Okay, pin number 11 is free, so we can connect it to pin number 11 like this. Right, okay, perfectly fine. Now we are left with these pins, right? So one by one we'll connect these pins to these digital free pins over here. So let's start with the extreme, this LED anode pin. So I would like to connect it to this pin number 2 of Arduino Uno R3 board. Right, I think that is going to be a better choice. So I'm selecting this green color, and let's connect this pin to this pin number 2. So that's how we can do it. Right, in the same way, we can connect. Just give me a short moment. I think it is 3.3 volt pin of Arduino Uno R3 board, and that's the LED anode. So, and this is DB7, DB6. Okay, that's not the correct connection I've defined over here. I will have to delete it. Why? Because it's an LED anode pin. So I cannot connect it with this digital pins of Arduino Uno R3 board. I have to connect it with some power pins. So these are the power pins. Now I've already used this 5 volt pin, right, for connecting this Arduino Uno R3 board to this LED. So now what we can do, we can use some other color. So I'm using this pink color wire, and I would like to connect this LED pin to this 3.3 volt pin of Arduino Uno R3 board. Right, so that's how you can give it some power. Now let's select this green color pin and connect this DB7 with this pin number 2. And then we can select some other color. So I would like to go with orange, and let's connect this DB6. So remember these values, okay? I'm connecting this DB6 to, I think, how about pin number 3? Yeah, pin number 3 will be a good option. So similarly, we can connect these pins also. So now I would like to connect this. Let's select some color first from here. So I'm selecting brown color, and I would like to connect this DB5 with. So we have this pin number 4 over here. Similarly, we can change the color now. So I'm taking this gray color, and I would like to connect this pin with pin number 5. Okay, so what all pins I've used? So I've used pin number 2, 3, 4 and 5. Right, perfectly fine. So I've successfully created a complete circuit. That's the circuit which I have created. And I hope you all have understood the whole concept, the whole circuit. If not, just try it out yourself. Definitely you will be able to create it on your own. I've showed you all these tips. You can go, if you're not able to do it, please let me know in the comment section. And now before proceeding to the next part, I would like to check the comment box. If I have anything to answer, I would like to answer that first. Just give me a short moment. Sarthak Rai, hello dear, I hope you are enjoying this lecture. Do try it out yourself, definitely you are going to love it, right? It's a great platform which you can enjoy, and you can learn robotics things on. It's a free online open source platform, and we have shooted about more than 25 lectures on this platform. So you can check out all those lectures, and definitely once you'll get familiar with the basic concepts, you are going to enjoy these advanced things which we are doing right now. And thank you very much for joining me in this tutorial at this time. Okay, if you have any queries, you can put it in the comment section. Right now I am not able to see any queries over here, so I am going to the next part. But in case if you are designing this thing on your own and you come across any issue, do let me know about the same so that I can help you in resolving your issue. So we are not going to make use of the block based coding. Definitely we'll use the text based coding, right? So that's how you can access the text based environment. Now I'm eliminating the code which is already there over here on this window. Let's start with accessing the header file which is required for making this LCD which we have defined over here in this in the circuit. If you want to make it functional, so for that we need to include this header file liquid crystal, right? And then you can put .h. So we guys use C++ coding on this platform, right? I've already told you about this thing in the previous lectures also. And then we can use this liquid crystal for creating a liquid crystal object. So I would like to create an object with this name LCD, and 12, 11 and 5, then 5, 4, 3, 2. Why I have chosen these numbers? It's because these are the pins which I have used over here, right? 11, 12, 2, 4, 5. These are the pins what I have used for connecting these, push buttons, for connecting this LCD with this Arduino Uno R3 board. That's the reason I have used these numbers over here, right? I hope you are able to understand it. Let's now define a variable. So that's the variable I would like to assign it, this 12. Why? Because I've connected this pin. Just a second, let me just show it to you. So R5, this register select pin, I've connected it to pin number 12 of this Arduino Uno R3 board. That's the reason I have assigned this variable this value 12. Similarly, we can have another variable. Let's use S, okay, random variable. Then we can use a flag variable, int flag. We can define it like this. And then let's have a variable in which we can store the time. So this is how we can do it. Then let's have a constant int hours. So HS is equals to 8. I hope you know why I have defined 8 over here, because that's this first push button I've connected it. The second push button I've connected it to this pin number 8, and the first one I've connected it to pin number 9. So for this first one, I am going to use another variable, and here let's make it MS, and I am going to make use of this value 9, right? And then we can have this state 1, then state 2, right? Just define these variables first. Definitely when I will tell you the whole concept, these whole things will be more clear to you, right? You will be able to understand all these things in much better way. So then we can have this setup function where we are going to define this begin function which can help us in making that LCD on, right? So for switching on the LCD, we can use this lcd.begin function. Simply we can now close this setup function like this, and now we are left with this loop, right? So these are two functions which are must for us to define if we are creating some circuit on this Tinkercad platform. Let's now set the cursor first. So that's the property I can use for setting the cursor. I would like to set it to 0, 0. If you don't know the answer why I have set it to 0, 0, please do check out the previous tutorial. Definitely you'll come to know about the same, right? Then we can make it s+1. So it's a counter variable I've used over here, and every time this loop function will get executed, the value of s will get incremented by 1, right? Then we can have this lcd dot, what do you want, what would you like to print on the lcd, what would you like to see on the lcd? So the first thing I would like to see is let's make it time. Okay, so now how to calculate the time? Now that's what we have to define the code for. So lcd dot print we can use first. You know, that's the object which I've defined over here, right? So this is what I'm using right now over here. So whatever I'm going to put inside this print function, which I've used with this LCD, so that thing will get reflected on the LCD, right? When we will start the simulation process, then we can have this H, and then simply you can copy this entire thing from here. You can put it over here like this, and I'm changing it to colon. Okay, and then we can put, then we can have the value of m. Have we defined this over here on the top or not? We haven't defined anything for the minute part, right? So let's do that quickly. I would like to copy this and paste it over here, and then we can change it to m. Let's remove it from here. Yeah, now we can change it to m like this. So this is going to fetch for us the minute part, and then again we can copy this code and we can put it over here. Now the only thing that we are left with is the second part. So H is for hour, M is for minute, and S is for second. That is absolutely right. Okay, so we are almost there. LCDS, right? Now let's check some conditions. So for that we have to use this if control statement. If flag, the value of flag is smaller than 12 at any time, if it happens, so I would like to see this thing getting reflected on the LCD. So LCD dot print am, it should be am, right? And if so, what I am doing over here, let me just cut it and put it next to it, and let's copy this entire thing and I'm putting it over here. So if this condition is there, if this condition becomes true, if flag becomes equal to 12, then it should be PM, right? It should be PM. And if flag is greater than 12, then also it should be PM, right? Okay, and what should happen if the flag becomes equal to 24? So at that time the flag value should again change to 0. So we'll start again from 0. So that's how we can do it, right? It's a very simple thing. If you're able to understand it, it is fine. If you're not, then please go and check out the previous tutorials I have shooted on this platform. Definitely, once you will get a better idea of the basics, you will be able to understand these advanced things also. Now, I would like to clear the LCD. So for clearing it up, we can use this clear function like this. And then we can again check, put a condition over here. If A is equal to, just give me a short moment. I haven't put any condition for this seconds, right? Okay, so let's now define some conditions for this second, and let's make it s. If s is equals to 60, if it becomes equal to 60 at any point of time, then I would like it to again go to 0, and m should increase by 1. Because in 1 minute we have 60 seconds. So that's why M should get incremented by 1 if S becomes equal to 60. Now we can do the same thing with minute and hour also. So if M becomes equal to 60, it should become equal to 0, and the value of R, which is getting saved in H, should get incremented by 1. So that's how we can do it, right? And also we can get the flag value incremented by 1. So flag is equals to flag plus 1. Simply we can define it like this, right? And then what else can we do? So here we can put another condition. If h is equal to 13, if the value of h becomes equal to 13 at any point of time, so I would like it to change to 1, right? Because I want to again start from the beginning. Okay, so now the day is over. Again, in the from the next day, the clock should start from 12 or 1 again. Then let's now set the cursor again. So we can use this set cursor, and we can simply define 0, 1 over here. Instead of putting 0, 0, we need to put 0, 1, right? And then you'll have to put a semicolon. And let's print something on the LCD. So we can print something like this: hello, the day is over, right? Something like this we can print on the LCD. Okay, so I think everything is looking perfectly fine right now. No problem. When we'll run it, if we'll come across any error, definitely we'll resolve it. So we have to now digital read. What we have to digital read? Can anyone tell me that? In state 1, what we have to read digitally? We have to read this HS, right? Because from here we are going to get the output. We are going to get the input, sorry. Why? Because this pin number 8 of Arduino Uno R3 board is connected to the push button 2nd. That's why I have used this digital read with HS, right? And then we can simply put a check on this state 1. So if the state 1 is equals to, let's say 1, if it is equal to 1, then h should get incremented by 1, right? And the flag value should get incremented by 1. Like this we can do it. And then we can again put a check on the value of flag. That is absolutely right. So, it's a bit tough code, I know that, but you all will be able to understand it if you'll do it on your own. So what we have to do now, we can simply collect the code from here. We can copy the code from here and we can simply paste it over here like this. So h is equal to h plus 1, flag is equal to flag plus 1. If flag's value is smaller than 0, then lcd.print am. If flag value is equal to 12, then lcd.print pm. If flag value is greater than 12, then lcd.print pm. Right, and finally, when the flag value will become equal to 24, I would like it to go again 0. Right, and what else can we do? Let me just check from here. I think we can bring this one also into this scenario. We can put it over here like this. If suppose value of h becomes equal to 13 at any point of time, so it should go again equal to 1. It should become equal to 1 again. And I think this is it. Right. And then do we have to do the same thing for... see what we have done. We have used these codes. And then over here we checked the state 1, so we use this HS, and then we define this whole code. In the same way you can check the state of this MS also, right? You can do it with for MS also. So we can simply copy this whole thing and we can put it over here like this, and we just have to change this HS to MS like this. I think that will work fine now. So instead of state 1, we can put state 2 over here because it's a second push button. And then we have to now close this loop function. Let's start the simulation process and see what's going to happen. Okay, so I am getting some errors. Now, what are these errors? Just hold on for a moment. I am getting some errors over here. So, let me check from the beginning. Yep, so there are some errors over here. LCD.print. Now, why I'm getting an error in this line? It's perfectly fine. So, what it is saying? Class Liquid Crystal has no member named Set Cursor. Did you mean Set Cursor? Okay, so I haven't defined that Set Cursor properly. The spelling is not correct. It should be Cursor, not Cursor. Let me check this spelling of cursor here also. Yeah, here it is fine. Let me start the simulation again. Okay, so what else I'm getting is an error. LCD.m. Now, why is this an error? Okay, just because I haven't used this print with these statements. You know, that's the reason we are getting errors over here. I think now it will not give us any error. I started the simulation process. Okay, now the number of errors have reduced. Let's see. Okay, LCD.print. Now, what is the error over here? That's what we have to see. So, line number 27, LCD.print. Why it's an error? Okay, if I'll enclose it in between double inverted commas, then also it will give me an error. Let me check. So now if I'll run the simulation process, okay, so the number of errors have reduced. So you know, if you get errors when you run your code, please don't lose your heart, or please don't close the platform. Try to find out the errors. Try to eliminate the errors. Okay? The way I am doing it, you can do it in the same way. So, void loop expected at the end. Now, what it is asking me to put? Let me check. So, void loop is there. This is perfectly fine. And then we have used this if control statement. So we have used this if control statement. This is fine. It is ending here. It is starting here, ending here. It is starting here, ending here. Then it is starting here. But it is not ending anywhere. We have to put an ending to this if control statement. I think rest everything is fine except this. Okay, let's start the simulation again and see what are we going to get this time. Okay, so it has accepted our code. Wow, it has accepted our code finally, and we are able to get the output over here. See, the LCD is working. Yeah, because the we haven't put some it requires some resistance over here, right? This LCD might burn if you'll connect it directly to this Arduino Uno R3 board the way I have done over here. So for preventing it from burning, you can put some resistors over here with these wires, so you'll be able to protect it from getting burned in that way. So that's how you can get an output, and I'm able to see the timing over here. Yeah, I successfully developed this digital watch on Tinkercad. Let me now see the comment section. If you have any queries, definitely I would like to resolve your queries first before telling you again what all things I've done today in this class. Just a second, let me open my YouTube app. Yeah. Okay, so whenever you see the lecture, please do like and share this video. And also, do call your friends so that they can also come and join the channel and learn these amazing, amazing things. So for designing this thing, it's very easy, by the way. First of all, I would like to tell you that it's very easy. And that's the whole code which I've defined over here for this, digital watch. So I'm showing you the whole code again. So that's the beginning. And that's the whole code I have defined over here. You guys can just check it out. Fine. Try to develop this digital circuit on your own. In case you come across any issue, please put that issue in the comment section. Please do share it with me so that I can help you in resolving that issue. This is it from my side today in this lecture. Thank you very much for being there with me in this tutorial. Hope to see you in the next one very soon. Thank you very much. God bless you all and have a great, great day. Bye-bye, everyone.